Hello again, I'm Jackie. I just want to talk about what I went through when I found out that I had lupus. I've always known there was something wrong. I just wasn't sure what exactly was wrong. There were times that I would pass out and didn't remember anything. There were times that I would forget stuff. Like I'd be driving my car and forget where I was going. I would be in the grocery store and forget when I had went into the store to get. So I ended up getting sick. And along with the get sick, I end up with an infection in my gum line, and it was pretty deep in there. And he couldn't figure out what was wrong and what was causing it. And he'd gone in there quite a few times and tried to fix it, but he never could fix it, so he finally told me, you know, it's time to go back to the primary care. But luckily that last visit, my sister, who is a charge nurse over the operating room at our local hospital, had gone with me because she understands that medical term a lot better than I do. And they had begun talking between the two of them and had put one and two together, and that was the first I'd ever heard of lupus. Well, he recommended me go back to my primary care doctor and get tested. So did my sister. And if it hadn't been for my sister, I probably would be dead right now. Because the damage that had been done internally with autoimmune diseases, my heart is so enlarged that there's not much room between it and the sac surrounding my heart. And when I went, they took blood, which was only the beginning of blood being taken. Now I'm so used to it, I don't even feel the needle anymore. And my ANA DNA strand had came back reading 300 plus, which means it was, the chart is here, and I was like way up here off the chart. And it's never came down. With all the medications I'm on, all the infusions I'm on, which is a fancy word for just an IV, it's never came down. And my rheumatologist, which is the doctor you see when you have lupus, my rheumatologist told me it may never come down. That may just be how it is. That's just the way things are. And finding out I had lupus, I also found out that's usually 9 out of 10 not the only disease that you have. I found out that I also had fibromyalgia, then it went to RA, then it went to osteoarthritis, and it just never quits. You're always diagnosed with something else. And it's hard. It weighs more on your depression than anything. And you stay depressed all the time because your fatigue, which is a huge part of your life now, you can't seem to get out of bed. You have to literally pull yourself out of bed. And I do it just when my kids need something. I will literally pull myself out of bed for them. Or if something needs fixed, or if they lost something and need something found, and that's just how kids are. Going up the hall, it seems has been like easy 10 steps done quick. It's like running a relay race to me. I'm constantly in pain. My legs hurt and ache so much. My fingers hurt and ache so much. I have Reynolds syndrome, which is where your fingertips and the cold, they actually begin to turn white, and it's very painful. And you just have to keep rubbing your hands and rubbing your hands until eventually your fingertips turn back to normal. And it happens in your toes too. And every day is a struggle with something. My kids have grown to accept it, just like I've grown to accept it a long time ago. They're just now coming to terms with it. And they're coming to terms with me coming off my medication. I've been on it for 4.5-5 years straight, no breaks, every month, like clockwork. And I really think that I need a break. So they've come to terms with me and, you know, taking a break, and they understand the possibilities and what could happen with me taking a break. But they're okay. They're okay with it. If it hadn't been for my bottom jaw doing the way it did, I don't think I would have ever been diagnosed until it was too late. But anytime any one of you ever feel like there's something wrong with you, fight. Because I always know it is true. You know your body better than any doctor could ever know. You know when there's something wrong. And if you think there's something wrong, stand up for yourself. Because in the long run, ain't nobody else gonna do it for you. And I was told repeatedly how there was nothing wrong with you. You don't need anything. You know, you don't need no tests done like that. You're far from it. Even though I had the rash, what they call the butterfly rash. And I just thought that once upon a time that it was just part of my skin. That it was like a skin irritation or something, but it never would go away. It would fade out a little bit, but it was always there. And sometimes it would show up really, really pink. But now, since I've been on the infusion, I've gone into remission a couple times, but never more than 4 months. That's the longest I think I've ever been on it. And if any of you have any questions, please leave it in the description box down below, and I'll do my best to answer it. Or I'll make another video of it. I hope this helps anybody that's out there and is questioning whether or not they need help, or they questioning whether or not they need it. They have it. And please, if you like this video, hit the little bell down below and subscribe. Thank you, and God bless.